Yes, we have a listing already. The initial list that we got was 17 people, but there are more names coming up. But as I said, we have to build up cases. We have to get the data. We have to investigate them systematically to get the necessary data and to have a case folder for each, so we know who are the witnesses and what statements will be made to support the allegations, the death certificates, the autopsy results. Everything that is needed to prove a case has to be built up from scratch for many of them, because many of the preliminary investigations of these cases never materialized. So we have to build them up from scratch.
Where do we have
the timeline? Very soon. We think that it will be ripe for the filing by, hopefully by March 30. Hopefully by March 30. We can file these cases, no? March 30 or March 31, by Friday, we can file the cases.
Sir, to be clear, po, filed po against Congressman
Arlington? I don't know. I don't know yet. We look at the extent of it, because if a case will be filed, it will still have to undergo preliminary investigation, except for those who voluntarily gave statements, which already submit to the court for further action. But for those that who are not yet present, under the current rules, preliminary investigation will have to lie, or will have to be pursued to build up cases against other people who are not yet in custody or who have not yet submitted to the jurisdiction of the DOJ and to the courts.
Sir, 30 people, masyadong marami. Siguro mga ilan
kayong suspect na pinitigan? We're looking at a group of people, an organization within Negros Oriental that is possibly involved in this. Maybe a group of 7 to 10 people may be involved here in the murders that we are talking about.
Sir, could this 7 to 10 be in, the same people involved in the digam?
Very possible. They may intersect at some points, or they may have a lot in common with the digam murders. Okay.
Sa mga sabungero, wala bang indikasyon na may mga gusto rin magkanta ng mga suspect dun sa mga principal?
We just have to be patient. Intayin lang natin. We need a major break, but I think we will get it. Ito lang talaga itong trabaho na to. Patience is a key. Hindi tayo pwede rito maging impatient, kasi haste makes waste. Dito talaga kailangan na maingat tayo sa lahat ng ginagawa natin.
Malaking tao.
Tsaka matsaga.
Malaking tao yung tinitingnan ninyo na pwede nilang ikanta?
Possible. Possible. Very possible. Because you're talking about 34 people missing. And for this to be done, it needs a lot of resources for this to be done. So we'll see. We just have to wait properly and wait and then surmise. Wait for the proper break that we need for this case. Magkakaroon tayo yan. I'm pretty sure. That was the statement given to us a few days ago, maybe 10 days ago. But we'll see. We will know late, very soon kung saan talaga. Wala pa. Kaya nga gusto ko nang pumasok. Kasi I step out of the meeting from the visa issuing agencies, para nga bumalik na, so I can have some more work done on these cases. I have to be briefed about the latest statements made by the suspects with the NBI. So I have to call on people to brief me on these matters.
At last na lang yung kahapon na dito sa General Katapang, sinasabi niya na may 1,000 daw na kayo na pinag-usapan ng mga informal sectors inside Bilibid, na baka ililipat na sila para dun sa mga plano niyo dun sa loob ng
I am not yet in that stage of deciding for Muntinlupa or for Bucor. All of this will have to be discussed in cabinet also. This is a major movement of government property. We will have to take it up with the president. We will have to take it up with the Secretary of Finance. There are many other people who are involved in the process of deciding about government property. So we cannot take it upon ourselves to decide on our own. We have to consult the proper agencies who are involved.
Sir, paklaro
Philippines, meron 23 boys na pinaglalabasan ng langis.
Yun nga yung ating nitingnan. We want divers to come down to be able to calculate the rate of spillage to the ocean to know how much oil is pouring out of the tanker. And we asked the OCD to mobilize some of the divers from the armed forces. Our consultant suggested a way to be able to calculate that because he's a diving instructor and he's a naval man who knows the ins and outs of the sea disasters. That's why we got him as consultant to help us with this matter. Tinuturuan niya sila kung paano ikalkula yung rate of ascent. So pwede natin ikalkula kung ilan pa na iiwan at kung meron pa talaga na iiwan. Yan ang critical part dito.
Sir, ilang divers
at kailan? We will have to go back to Secretary Galvez on that. But that was already one of the things discussed yesterday. Okay?
Last
na, sir, yung appointment. Inihintay. Pero palabas na yan. Palabas na.